I'm smoking one of Mervyn Sayers' pokers. Kind of my style. From Ireland. Air. He seems like a really nice guy. If I ever get back to Ireland, I need to make a visit. So, ride down in Georgia. I'm smoking out of the right side of my mouth because I have a temporary back in here. I had a routine dental cleaning yesterday afternoon, and I thought there was something amiss. Well, one of my fillings was kind of half broken out. It was like there was a hole there, you know? So, sure enough, and I have a great dentist. And so he said, well, come on, how about tomorrow at 8 a.m.? It's like, whoa, that's quick. So I went in this morning. And that whole office just takes Halloween so seriously. So they were Alice in Wonderland. And the dentist was the Mad Hatter. So anyway, my friend Rod in Georgia is a carver, and he gave me the finger. It happens. For a tall pipe like this with a fairly small chamber, not real wide chamber, even for me it makes it kind of hard to get my little pinky in there and tamp. So the finger he gave me is carved out of antler, and it's a finger. So, thank you, Rod. Thank you, Rod. Yeah, I appreciate it. For giving me the finger. Smoking some Bill Bailey's Balkan from Dan Tobacco in Germany. For a while there, it was kind of my favorite Balkan. And it's still good. I think Balkan Supreme from Peter Stockaby, although I haven't tried any fresh stuff in a few years. All my stuff, I bought a couple of 5-pound bales back in like 2009, 2010. So I've cellared a lot of it. I have to say that is coming along very nicely. Remember the first time that I took a whiff of the tin note of Dunhill 965? It was like, wow. That is, number one, overwhelming. Number two, overpowering. Number three, oh, so good. Where was that? That might have been at Brian's shop down on South Broadway in Denver. I'll bet it was. Yeah, because he had some big bales of that stuff in there. Anyway, that's the kind of aroma, tin note, that Peter Stockaby Balkan Supreme gives you after about 10 years of cellaring. So, well, not quite 10. So I think that's probably my favorite Balkan. Bones posed that question. And it got me thinking, what is my favorite Balkan? And yeah, it's aged Peter Stockaby Balkan Supreme. Dan's, Bill Bailey's coming in second probably. I've tried a lot of them. They're all good. They're all certainly acceptable. But there are only a few that really, like, whew, stand out, and just, it's almost a perfume in the best sort of way. Recognize your tune. Yeah. So dentistry. My dad was a dentist. His dad was a dentist, who I never got to meet because he passed away before I was born. My grandfather on my dad's side. And none of us kids became dentists. I think he wanted us to, kind of. He was a little ambivalent about being a dentist himself, my dad. He actually always wanted to be a park ranger. That's what he really wanted to be. But his dad was a dentist. He was kind of, he was the only son, the youngest out of five kids. So I think he was kind of pressured to become a dentist. So for us kids, my brothers and I, it was kind of like the house painter who never paints his own house. We'd go in to his office on a Saturday, rarely, occasionally, and have our teeth cleaned, or rarely did we have any fillings. And my dad was no Nazi about sugar either. I mean, he enjoyed everything life had to offer, but yeah, he was not a dictator about sugar. So, we just had basically good teeth genetically, I think. So I never had any fear of dentists. You know, and his friends were all dentists. So we skied with them, we hunted with them, we generally recreated with them. So, it's like, I don't know. I just never had any hang-ups about dentistry. A lot of people do. So, but it's so important. Oh my gosh. Oh, the finger. Thank you, Ron. It does seem like a lot of dental health is genetics plays a part. But I'm mostly UK origin DNA, and mostly. There's some other stuff going on in there. But, God, you know, in the UK, when I've been over there, it's like, I thought dental stuff was free here. What's going on? Like, oh my gosh. Maybe it's the water. I don't know. But anyway, I had a great time with my dentist today. I shouldn't say that. I mean, he was like drilling, and we had to re-shoot me up with numb stuff. I don't even know what that was. But once, an additional time, it was like, hey, at least my teeth were really clean from the periodontal we did yesterday. Perfect timing to have somebody else in your mouth. Anyway, they're all about Halloween, and today is Halloween. So, I have that Bigfoot outfit. I just wasn't really into it. And I could always go as a fireman. That's kind of the default. But, yeah, I just wasn't in the mood. But this morning at the dentist's office, they are into it. Every year they are. And so, this year the theme was Alice in Wonderland. Yeah. Crazy. I'm glad they have fun. Mervin, a very nice pipe. I really like this pipe, thank you. Mervin Sayers. Yeah, he has an Etsy. You can just Google Sayers Pipes Ireland, or even Sayers Pipes, S-A-Y-E-R-S. Plus, I think he's a really nice guy. Brian Doran got me. He's a electrician, I think, in Wheeling, West Virginia, and he carves pipes. Doran Pipes. And one popped up on eBay, and it was like, no, I don't need another pipe. But I love that pipe. You know how it all is, you know. So when I get it in the next few days, I'll do a little video on it. Yeah, Bill Bailey's is pretty good. I think if you bought a wad of it and then put it in a jar and let it sit for a few years, of course that's probably true of almost any tobacco, except maybe some aromatics might not age very well. But probably everything else would do better with a couple years on it. So anyway. Complete with a fingernail. That's great. Thanks, Rod. Thanks for thinking of me. And thanks, Murph, for making a nice pipe.